5 Reasons Why Pawn Stars is Fake. For years, Pawn Stars has been claiming that it's a reality show. However, a few facts have made me believe that this is a total lie. Below are 5 reasons that lead me to conclude that Pawn Stars keeps us in a fake illusion. Top 5. Subway is in the show for a reason. Oftentimes during the show, I notice the staff having Subway or walking into the place. Subway tastes like heaven, but heading there every single time? This planted seeds of suspicion in my mind, and they proved to be right. Subway is one of the biggest sponsors to the show. All those discussions of sandwiches with full menu names, stating sauces, sub sizes, and every time the staff enjoys the Subway, it is all paid content. Subway wrappers swinging around the episode are actually an advertisement. Top 4. Experts are hired by the producers. While there is an impression cast that the expert is called locally, there is a whole scheme that is not shown. The experts chosen are made sure that they can perform well on the TV screens. They are called and arranged beforehand. Staff members help train them and make sure they are presentation worthy. Moreover, it's also a boost for the experts hired, as Pawn Stars is indirectly advertising them, thus giving them more clients. What looks totally spontaneous on TV has an actual mastermind involved behind it. This again makes Pawn Stars away from being all realistic. Top 3. Merch is not shown on camera. Pawn shop or a fan-based lobby? Indeed, a difficult question after knowing the reality. Inside the pawn shop, one would definitely find his way to history. But he also will find his way to the lobby where there are piles of t-shirts printed with Chum Lee on them. Moreover, there are autographs sold for $25 each. This reality has never been viewed on the screen. The cameras only show the pawn shop and purchases made there. It never made its way to the lobby. Needless to say, the gold and silver pawn shop generates millions of dollars from selling items that attract the tourists on the visit. The shop is for sure serving more than its purpose, and the second place is still hidden from the camera. Top 2. All items are vetted beforehand. It looks like a random customer walks into the store with a masterpiece in his hand, knowing more than relevant details about the product and actually earns thousands of dollars. Looks unrealistic? It sure is. How can someone even know the organic details about a 100-year-old object? It's only a true enthusiast for history could know. Every day, dozens of deals are made. Only few are carefully picked that would make the TV ratings explode and are interesting enough to keep the viewers engaged. Also, customers are taught how to act, and what they must speak is usually scripted. The negotiation process is completely staged, too. Prices are arranged behind the camera and then redone in front of it. The intense negotiation is all filmed. I am disappointed. The negotiation part used to be my most enjoyable part from the episode. Top 1. Customers are mostly tourists. Although Pawn Stars shows the shop as a collection of antiques, it is more of a tourist destination. About 5,000 people visit the shop each day. Some of them spend hours admiring the collection of Harrisons over all these years. Museum tour? Maybe. People have to wait for hours in long queues just to get inside. And while inside the shop, one would never find Chum Lee or any other owner sitting at the back of the counter waiting to deal with them, as shown in the show. In fact, he would rarely ever find them because they just give one visit per week. There are other people managing the store, and the main members screened on television are actually considered as stars. This all brings us to the conclusion that while many things shown are true, others are just marketing techniques to earn from.